Buried by the sand, a mystery to everyone, created by some long dead hand. I've heard your call through time. They gathered together from all across the land, most had never met before. They knew that night that many might die, but they swore the fleet would never touch this shore. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. A hundred clans met in the valley as night began to fall. The watchtowers burned in a hundred circles as they began to call. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. The night around them grew darker and darker until they could barely see. The fires burning within each circle as the clans drew on the moon's energy. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. They stored Diana's power within their own auras until they began to glow. Each priestess held them back until the right moment when together they would let it all go. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. A thousand candles stood down in the valley, and sometimes one would flare and die out. The high priestess raised her sword straight up in the air, and in their minds they heard her say, "Now." Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they see who had more power on their side. The dammed up power leapt to her sword, and then straight up in the air. A crash of thunder knocked them all to the ground, and lightning blazed beyond compare. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. The mighty storm flew straight across the ocean, out toward the Spanish fleet. They were helpless in the face of its fury, and they knew that they faced defeat. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they'd see who had more power on their side. For those who had died trying to hold the power, they made a burial mound. The English praised themselves for being so lucky, but the true heroes were never found. Treachery, false promises and lies, treachery, blacker than the night, treachery, and though they must hide, they see who had more power on their side. The wind rushes through the stones, sitting alone on the hill, cold and gray and alone. A crown for the king who was killed. Why have you gone and left us alone? Back to the earth, the wind and the stones. Were you born too soon for others to know the truth of the vision you saw? Your sword upon your breast, you sleep in your barrow mound, where you were laid to rest, with the stones for your final crown. To the earth, the wind and the stones. Were you born too soon for others to know the truth of the vision you saw? Ages have passed while you slept silently, your true name forgotten by all. Your time and your deeds are legendary, but they've passed like the leaves of fall. Why have you gone and left us alone? Back to the earth, the wind and the stones. Were you born too soon for others to know the truth of the vision you saw? Late at night, neath the moon, when the mist is as white as snow, a figure sadly mourns the king. Is it Merlin with his head bowed low? Have you gone and left us alone? Back to the earth, the wind and the stones. Were you born too soon for others to know the truth of the vision you saw? voice like a whisper. Oh, thank you for coming. I've been alone for so long. There's a power between us. Oh, can't you feel it? In this magical village, we've come home. See the earth, the sky, and the trees. Feel the flow of life's energy. Raise the power, feel it flow through. Two 150, all are attuned. In the tents and the people, the cars and the campers, there's a sharing of spirit with ourselves, with the land. Reach out and take it. It is yours for the asking. Just give in return a helping hand. See the earth, the sky, and the trees. Feel the flow of life's energies. Raise the power, feel it flow through. 250, all are attuned. I see in the faces a special new magic. A spirit's aborning from our hearts and our minds. Working together with the land all around us, a magical power comes alive. Sky and the trees. Feel the flow of life's energies. Raise the power, feel it flow through. 250, all are attuned. A dance through the village to a bonfire circle. We sing out our praises to the land, to the year. Oh, feel the wonder to be part of this cycle, to be one with the earth and stars so dear. Sky and the trees. Feel the flow of life's energies. Raise the power, feel it flow through. 250, all are attuned. And so as we journey, the memory lingers. Let it not be forgotten. Take it home, let it grow. What we all share in spirit will unite us forever. For we're part of the earth, part of the whole. See the earth, the sky, and the trees. Feel the flow of life's energy. Raise the power, feel it flow through. Two 150, all are a sacred temple gleaming pale like snow, served by those who honored gods that very few now know. Until there came a day when a priest from far away said the temple must go. He said the time had come for all to worship a new way. A god both harsh and stern had come to hold all in his sway. Then from the frightened crowd, a voice spoke strong and proud, "Our gods will remain." Out stepped a fair lady dressed in white like purest milk. At her side a tall man stood and all were quickly still. "Our gods give love, not fear. We will not have yours here. We'll see who has the strongest will." Late that night, neath silver moon, they met on temple ground. The priest and priestess faced the man while all the folk stood round. His curse came like a cloud until all heads were bowed, and then there came a sound. From the darkness came the sound of voices raised in song. The priest and priestess sang the moon song and their faces shone. Then a shaft of light came from the moon on high and touched them until they glowed. They shone with light as they did turn and spoke both soft and clear. "We have come, we heard the summons, now bring your God here. We wish to see the one who would tell us to be gone." But the priest turned and ran in fear. All of us must face the choice of what will rule our lives. Will we live by fear and darkness, or live by love and light? For though years have passed by, the old gods have not died, and some still call them from the sky.
Yeah.
She ruled o'er all the year. Winter, summer, spring, and fall. And every night was filled with her
and every
ship floated to the ground. It floated without a sound. They didn't know what they would find. No ship had passed this way in a long time. They were the first in 10,000 years, and now they'd come back to their home. But silence reigned below. Silence and darkness below. The maps they had were so old. 10 long eons old. But they found the blue-green world. Third of a string of 10 pearls. And now they hung night sky, and they turned on the searchlight beam. But nothing could be seen. Not a thing could be seen. They searched for the ancient port. The land had changed, they weren't sure. And then they saw a great stone from the days of the builders of old. And they stood in wonder, in awe and fear at the ruined might laid out below. And still they were alone. Still they were alone. They landed and stepped out in the night. The wind sang through the ruins beyond their sight. Could this be the planet of their birth? The legendary home of man called Earth. But where were the cities, the people and the ships of an empire that had touched the stars? The lonely wind was cold and hard. The wind blew cold and hard. They searched for many a day, and the ruins they found could only mutely say that man was here no more. His hand no longer touched these shores, and the silent sentinels of beauty and of strength sat round the globe, wasting day by day. And so they turned away. They sadly turned away. And And so they got in their saucer craft and said goodbye to man's home at last. They left the pyramids and the great stone circle in which hid the clues to the glories of man's great works and a message to follow if you can. For the primitives who might someday understand, for the primitives who might one day understand.
Of the land of Minor, there are tales of a man who had power greater than the greatest of kings. His hand could be felt in all the deeds of the time, as gentle as the wind and as irresistible as the sea. Yet who he was and where he came from, no one knew. He gave no name, and when asked who he was, he would smile and play another tune on his many-string kalan. So he came to be called the Songsmith. And the power and the magic of his singing were unsurpassed, even by the greatest of sorcerers. He came to a land that was divided and without purpose. And when he left after many lifetimes of men, he left behind a unified people, a multitude of songs, and a legend.
Songsmith, songsmith, sing to me a tune, and let me share that magic rare found beneath the moon. I come from the mountains beyond the western shore, though that is not my home. Spells of great magic I learned in days of yore, but that is not the thing for which I'm known. They call me Songsmith,
Songsmith,
Songsmith, maker of melodies. Of all the titles I have earned throughout antiquity, that one is most truly me. I've traveled through cities now long gone to dust, and wandered many a mile. I fought in great battles with swords now turned to rust, till at the thought of war I sadly smile. So call me Songsmith,
Songsmith,
Songsmith, maker of melodies. Of all the magic I have learned on both sides of the sea, my songs can do the greater deeds. I've sailed across the ocean to the land where dragons dwell, where men are rarely seen. I held the greatest of them all in a mighty magic spell and set all his captives free. But I'm the Songsmith,
Songsmith,
Songsmith. of melodies. For all the mighty spells I know and ancient mysteries, spells of song I'd rather weave. I've talked with the elven lords in their halls of stone, and great wisdom I receive. Yet there came a time when I knew that I must go, so sadly I took my leave. For I'm the songsmith, maker of melodies. And though the magic of the elves is now lost beneath the sea, in my songs it can still be seen. Oh, there are a thousand things I've done and wonders I have seen on my age-long road. And I've taught my songs of magic in all the places I have been, for this is part of my goal. So call me Songsmith, maker of melodies. And when my travels are all done and my purpose is achieved, my songs will be remembered more than me.